Richie Adams was a 6'9" former basketball star who had the opportunity to take his talents to the NBA and make a name for himself. But because of drug abuse and bad decision making, he now sits in an upstate correction facility for a murder he claims he didn't commit. Having grown up in the Grand Concourse section of the Bronx, Adams dropped out of Alpha E. Smith High School as a sophomore and stayed out of school for 2 years before enrolling at East Harlem's Benjamin Franklin High School in 1978. It was Adams and a band of other talented players who helped transfer Franklin into the nation's top-ranked high school in the fall of 1979. Walter Berry, who sat out the season after transfer from DeWitt Clinton in the Bronx, would lead Franklin to a city championship in 1980. Adams, who failed to earn a diploma at Franklin, later earned a GED at Massachusetts Bay Community College. This was his last stop before joining the UNLV Running Rebels. He played for the Running Rebels under Jerry Tarkany from 1981 to 1985, where he dominated the middle. He was twice named Pacific Coast Atlantic Associate Player of the Year and set the school career rebounding record. After his first season at UNLV, Adams went back to the South Bronx, where he ran into trouble. Whenever he went home, it was always something, Tarkany said. We knew we'll get a call about one thing or another. Begged by Tarkany to return to school, Adams went back to Las Vegas, but he had missed too many classes and was forced to sit out the season as a redshirt. In each of his last two seasons at UNLV, Adams claimed he used drugs. Despite his professed drug abuse, Adams continued to excel on the court. In each of his last two seasons, in which the Rebels finished in a combined record of 57 wins and 10 losses, he was selected the Conference Player of the Year. He finished at UNLV with 1,168 points. Adams signed a contract with the Long Island Knights, hoping to showcase his talent for NBA scouts. In June 1985, he was drafted by Washington Bullets, the 81st pick in the fourth round. But on the same day that he was drafted by the Bullets, Adams was arrested on charges of stealing a car. Eventually, he was cut, and after a 2-year stint with a team in Argentina, Adams returned to New York City. On September 25, 1988, Adams was arrested in Manhattan after the police said he put a gun in the face of a woman at a cash machine. Adams was charged with first-degree robbery. He was also arrested 15 days later in a purse snatcher incident, which resulted in the first of his grand larceny charges. In April 1989, while still out on bail, Adams was arrested for snatching a purse of a 68-year-old woman in the Grand Central Station during rush hours. He fled for the scene of the crime wearing a UNLV sweatshirt. Finally, Adams was sent to an upstate correction facility that year and would not return until 1994. When he returned, he moved in with his mother in her Bronx apartment. According to residents, Adams' behavior hadn't changed. He was still running the streets using drugs, which contributed to his 1996 arrest for the killing of a 14-year-old Norma Rodriguez. She was found dead one floor below Adams' mother's apartment. She was bunched to death near the elevator. A bloody Adidas sneaker size 13.5 was found outside the building. Adams was convicted of the crime, but insists he never committed it. Richie Adams urges that the sneaker was planned. He wears a size 17. He insisted not a 13.5. And investigators never linked Norma's DNA to the gym shoe in Richie's home or blood found on paint chips and a pair of jeans in the same location. Personally, I don't know if Adams committed this crime or not, but what I do know is today's youth can learn something from the Richie Adams story, and that's what inspired me to write it. Thank you very much.